everyone, it's Nina Marie Trapani. I'm bringing you a unique fold card using the Newton's Rain Boots stamp set from Newton's Nooks Designs. This cute little set reminded me of the classic rhyme, April showers bring May flowers. And that prompted me to create a really unique card design that features both aspects of that rhyme. So let's get started on how I created this card. I have the Newton's Rain Boots stamp set and the Raindrop stencil. I'm going to be using both of these today to create my card. My card base is created from some watercolor paper because I am planning on doing some watercoloring and adding some more wet mediums onto my project. So I want to make sure I have a paper that's going to hold up to that. I'm starting by stamping Newton onto the corner of my card on the left-hand side with some intense black ink because I am going to be doing some watercoloring, like I said, and this ink is perfect for that. On a piece of scrap paper, I am stamping one of the ducks and some flowers to use to decorate my card. Here's where I'm going to start creating the fun fold effect. I'm using my Tim Holtz design ruler and my Tim Holtz craft knife so that I can cut off a portion of my front card panel. The idea is that the front of the card looks into the inside of the card, and that's going to create this really fun effect of Newton sitting in the sunshine with a rain shower coming behind him. And I think this is a really cute and unique way to be able to create a fun card scene. After creating the cut along the diagonal of my card, I am going to take my fussy cut scissors and cut around the rest of the image so that I can get that really unique effect of this image partially cut out of my card panel. And here you can see how this is going to look after we have cut this out. You're going to be able to see to the inside of the card really well, and I think this is so fun. Now, like I said, I'm watercoloring my image. You don't have to do that. You could do whatever kind of coloring you want for this image. I thought watercoloring would be really fun, and I also just love watercoloring in general, so this is why I chose this medium. Now, for watercolors, I did pick out the Altenew watercolor set. This is a fun set of 36 different colors that really work well in creating some fun spring cards because there's a lot of really bright and happy colors in this set. As I'm coloring, I'm making sure to add just a little bit of shading to this image. I'm not focused on any light source or anything like that. I just want to add some nice color and give these images just a little bit of dimension. I picked out springy kind of colors for the flowers. I used purples, pinks, blues, and also yellow for the ducks. I thought the ducks were so cute. Now, of course, this cat is Newton in the stamp set. However, I like to be able to color cat images just like my own cats. I have four different cats, and this one I'm coloring to look like my cat Maddie. She's a black and white tuxedo cat, but her face is completely black. She has white on her belly, and so because you can't see any of that in this image, this cat is going to be completely black as I'm coloring it. Makes it very easy to color in. Finished up coloring the little images that I had stamped onto that scrap paper so that I can cut those out later. And here's where I'm going to work on creating the seam. I started first by applying a little bit of green to the bottom portion of the card because that's going to, of course, be the grass. Then on the front and the inside panels, I'm going to add a little bit of blue watercoloring. And this is the sky, of course. So as we're adding some color, I'm just kind of blending it out with a little bit of water, leaving it very loose and textured. I'm bringing in the Raindrop stencil at this point and some Peacock Feathers Distress Ink. I'm using Distress Ink, not Distress Oxide. I want the Distress Ink because this really looks nice when layered on top of other colors, and it also reacts well with texture paste, which I'm going to be applying over top of this stencil to create the look of shiny raindrops. So as I continue blending in some of these raindrops, I did apply the stencil down at an angle for just a little bit of movement and interest. Then I'll bring in the transparent gloss texture paste and apply this over top of the ink blending I just did. I didn't clean off my stencil or anything. I just went right back in with the paste, making sure not to contaminate the paste that's getting stained with the ink with the paste that's in the jar. I removed the stencil, leaving the paste exposed, which is now allowing me to take a little bit of glitter to sprinkle onto these raindrops, giving them a little bit of sparkle and shine. The glitter that I'm using here is the Wow Atlantis glitter. I just love the chunky glitter that's in this. It's so beautiful, and that beautiful teal color really looks nice. Matches well with the peacock feathers. I brought in some Unicorn Dust, Simon Says Stamp Glitter too, for a little bit of intense glitter, and also it kind of pairs well with the teal for a little bit more of a clear effect. I did want to add some clouds to this, so I used a Lawn Fawn cloud die to cut out three different clouds using watercolor paper, and I'm going to start attaching these down, some on the front and some in the back. Same with the little duck and the flowers. I added the duck along the bottom portion of the scene, and I'm popping the flowers up over top of the flowers that are in the rain boots. I thought this would look cool and add some nice dimension. All of the clouds, including the ones on the inside, are popped up with foam tape. This just adds a little bit of fun dimension to the scene, and it also gives the inside of the car a little bit of interest. One of the sentiments in the stamp set is cute boots make everything better, and I just thought that was so fun. This is a great card to give to somebody for a little bit of encouragement and some fun. I love the sparkly raindrops and the cute little image of my cat, Maddie, popping out of the rain boots. You could color this cat to look like a cat of yours, or maybe the person you're giving this card to has a cat and you can color it to look like theirs. That would really make somebody's day if they get a card that looks like their cat. Well, I hope that you have enjoyed this video featuring this unique fold that gives a really cool look into the inside of the card and creates a really fun scene for the entire design. Thanks so much for tuning in today. I will be back again very soon with more to share. But until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye!